Electors may be carrying out their official function in selecting a president on behalf of the voters they represent today, but they won't be able to heal the political wounds still raw. And on display at state houses across the nation. One of those electors in New York, former President Bill Clinton, cast his vote for Hillary Clinton, smiling but candid about the forces he saw conspiring against his wife.
I watched her battle through that bogus email deal. She fought through everything, and she prevailed against it all. But, you know, then with the end, we had the Russians and the FBI deal, which she couldn't prevail against that. But she did everything else and still won by 2.8 million votes.
Pushing back on those hard feelings, Donald Trump railed against the idea advocated by some Democrats that electors revolt and throw the election to the House of Representatives, tweeting, "If my many supporters acted and threatened people like those who lost the election are doing, they would be scorned and called terrible names." Trump now defends the Electoral College, a system he once slammed as unfair.
I never appreciated it until now, how genius it was, what they had in mind.
President Obama told National Public Radio Democrats have bigger problems than an election system he's described as antiquated.
If we're not showing up, if we're not in there making an argument, then we're going to lose. And we can lose badly, and that's what happened in this election.
Trump's top advisors are still tearing into the notion that Russian hackers tipped the balance in the election.
The entire nonsense about the electors trying to use the Russian hacking issue to change the election results is really unfortunate. I think that actually undermines our democracy more than any other conversation that we're having.
But even a fellow Republican, Senator John McCain, said Moscow's interference is a troubling sign of the times.
This is the sign of a possible unraveling of the world order that was established after World War II, which has made one of the most peaceful periods in the history of the world.